हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स प्रोसीड फर्दर. लेट्स कंटिन्यू आवर डिस्कशन इन नाउ एक्सेप्शन हैंडलिंग. सो अनकॉट एक्सेप्शन. सो व्हाट विल हैपन इफ यू डू नॉट हैंडल द एक्सेप्शंस इन जावा? दैट्स व्हाट द टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन. वी हैव टेकन वेरी स्मॉल प्रोग्राम क्लास exc जीरो. होप इट इज विजिबल. exc जीरो इज द नेम ऑफ द क्लास. ओके, हैंस द फाइल नेम विल बी exc जीरो डॉट जावा. इट कंटेन्स अ मेन फंक्शन एंड observe the statements written in the inside, that is int d equal to 0 and int a equal to 42 divided by d. So int d equal to, yeah, here let me highlight this. Yeah, fine. Int d equal to 0 and int a equal to 42 divided by d. 42 divided by d during runtime, what will happen? It substitutes the value of d. Whenever you compile the program, it will substitute the value of d to 0, because value of d you have initialized to 0. So what will happen? 42 divided by 0, compiler is trying to obtain the value. What will be the value? Our result is infinity, isn't it? So this is an erroneous situation or exceptional condition for the system. But unfortunately, we haven't managed any such you haven't used any such mechanisms to manage such type of runtime exceptions. So it will turn out to be an error message. So it will result an error message. Observe here, the error message is java.lang.arithmeticException. Okay, this is the type of the exception will be mentioned. Concentrate on the pointer, otherwise let me highlight this once again. Yeah, here this area. Okay, concentrate java.lang.arithmeticException. Okay, and the type of the exception is, since divided by zero exception, it is mentioned like this. And where exception is observed, so exception is caught. Here exception is caught at the main function. What is the name of the program that will be printed? See, name of the program is exe0, as you can go through. Name of the program, observe, exe0 is the name of the program. So exe0 in the main function, the observe, it is obtained in the main function. Exception is thrown inside of the main function. Check the line number 1, this line number 2, line number 3 and line number 4, exception is arrived. Keep this in mind. So check the output, check the error message. So exe0 is the class name. Inside that, in the main function, right, what will happen? File name is printed, exe0.java at line number 4, exception is caught. This is the error message we are going to get. Fine. So that erroneous situation, that exception situation, can be handled with the help of the try catch block as per our previous discussion. So we are going to use them. Please observe the program carefully. I have considered another program, class exc. Hope it is clearly visible in the video. exe2, let me highlight this as well. Check the statement which I am highlighting once again, that is a try block. So two variables, say d and a, are declared inside the main function. But inside the try block is used to monitor the exceptions. So inside the try block, what is done? D is initialized to 0 and a equal to 42 divided by d. Both the statement you have written inside the try block. So in the second statement of the try block, what will happen? Exception condition arises. That exception condition, once it arises, since you have monitored that exception, it is caught and necessary action to be taken by the corresponding catch block. Control will be changed its position from the particular line, this particular line, to corresponding catch block. Check the pointer carefully. So what will happen? Immediately control will look into the corresponding catch block. Corresponding catch block should be, see the type of the error generated, that is divided by zero error. So check for the corresponding catch block. Arithmetic It belongs to the category arithmetic exception, so that is included already. Remember, arithmetic exception is a built-in class of the parent exception, okay, where exception is the built-in class of parent throwable. Please remember these things. So its object, formal object, is mentioned. So necessary action, in the sense we are printing the appropriate message, check system.out.println division by 0, isn't it? Then system.out.println, this is after catch statement. You please observe the output, and before that observe the program carefully. How hope the program, entire program is visible, just check where exception is caught, in which position exception is caught, and what will happen once the exception is caught. Observe the pointer carefully, okay, see this one, right? Once the exception is caught at the particular position, what it does is, it so control will change its path to catch block. Control will go to the catch block immediately. So see the type of the exception you have mentioned in the catch block, that is arithmetic exception. So system.out.println, this is as a part of a handling mechanism, so we want to display a message. We are terminating the program normally by displaying a message, system.out.println. What type of exception it is, that is a division by 0, you can print infinity as well. Please remember, this exception type, arithmetic exception, this is a built-in class. This arithmetic exception is a built-in class of Java exception hierarchy, that for this arithmetic exception, exception, that is exception, is a superclass. For exception, throwable is a superclass. Please remember this. Hence, because of the position of the control, okay, we are unable to see the message. This particular statement, which one? See, we have inside the try block at last, we have one particular statement. This will not be printed. This, that is, for sake of convenience, we have written like this. So the statement, the particular statement, is not printed on the output. That is not printed on the output. You have to think why it is not printed on the output. Even though it is a part of a try block, right? It is not printed because just prior to that system.out.println, exception is caught in this position. Soon after the exception is caught, what will happen? Control will change its positions to the position to the corresponding catch block. Hence, it is unable to see the next statement inside the try block. Please remember this very, very important topic. If you have any doubt, you ask. Thank you for watching.